So this is how my fridge looks like. This is how my door portion of the refrigerator looks like. A bit. This is how my first rack looks like. So basically I have stuffed here with a few say chocolates, and these lemons I've kept at the top because they are almost about to dry, and I should not forget them in using, so they should be visible to me. So I have kept these at the top. These are few cake accessories and cake related stuffs which I've kept over here. This is few sprinklers, food colors, baking powder, and also if you come to this side, I have kept pizza and pasta related stuffs, maybe your mustard sauce, mixed herbs, chili flakes. Here in this bottle I have kept some kesar. Here I've kept a lollipop which my kid loves. This is again a pizza mix, and these are a few sesame seeds and some poppy seeds which I've kept. So this is how my first rack looks like. Okay, this is my second rack. As you can see, I have kept only masalas here. If I zoom in, I show a bit. These are all masalas which I use daily. May it be a sabji masala, sambar masala, or some spices which I use here. And this is some leftover flour which I've stapled and put it in a packet like this. And if you see back behind it, there is some dip. There is a cheese dip here, and I have kept some rasam powder in this. Bottle, and if you behind it I have kept cooking soda. So I have organized it like this. I have kept it like this just because in case I'm in a hurry, especially in the morning when there is a lot of pressure while cooking, it's easy for me to just take it out and then keep it back to its place, rather than putting it whole in a format of box and then you keep on searching which is what. By just by looking at the color, I find out this is what I need and I just take it. Most of the time your base of this will be loaded with all the spice powders. To avoid that, I have just placed a small polythene bag. If you can see, there is a small polythene bag which I have put here, because of which if whatever masala that falls maybe on this, and then I can clean it easier. So this is how my second rack looks like. So this is my third rack. You can see there's a kasuri methi here, there are few pickle bottles, and this is homemade murabba, homemade pickle, and there is also some ketchup bottles, and all ingredients that are required basically for Chinese. This is tomato sauce, and I've kept here all soya sauce. This is again a tomato ketchup bottle that goes in handy. There's a few olives which I have kept here, and behind you have vinegar and chili sauce also. So this is how my rack looks like. Okay, this is how my last rack looks like. If you see it from far, there is a lot of space here. You can also stack your water bottles right here, but the place where I live, there is no much requirement of cold water. So what I have done is I have just kept this extra rava which I have used, and this I have just put a rubber band like this. This is idli rava what I have kept here, because if you keep it outside, there is every possibility that they may catch flies, and so I have kept it like this. And this is some nachni flour or ragi flour, and this is excess of tomato sauce which I have. This is some also this is some jawar flour which I have. So all left outs I have rack which I am using here to store vegetables. Though I do not keep too many vegetables, I just keep vegetables which are required only for say 2 to 3 days, and then I prefer buying them fresh. Since the fridge is very small, and it becomes very difficult when you load with too much of vegetables, and you get confused. All I've kept in this paper, I have just kept my methi and palak. I have washed them fresh, dried them, and then I have just keep it. I have just kept it in these papers. If you can also use polythene bags if you have. Now since in market they have stopped giving polythene bags, and you find any cloth bag like this easily in any of the vegetable store. In one I have kept lady's finger, and the other one I've kept beans. And you can see I put in some carrots, some cucumbers, ridge gourd, and some brinjals over here. I've kept it in this manner so that it becomes very easy for me to pick it up whenever I'm in urgency. I like to keep it like this, so I have kept only few vegetables, but there is a lot of space here which you can use. Keep also on top of this also you can stack few, you can use some polythene bags or some say cloth bags, and keep other vegetables also on top of this. So this is how my vegetable box looks like. Right on the top I have a partition here, which I keep all the storage items, like maybe whatever is extra, like some ground nuts, this is idli rava again, this chili powder and some ghee, these all I like to keep it here. As you can see, this is a small box. If you open it, then I have these fresh flowers which are required for puja on daily basis. And what I do is I just keep these flowers and cover a polythene bag, and also I close it. By doing this, my flowers will remain fresh and intact. This is a walnut box. This is an extra box of walnut, so I've just saved it here. A dry fruit box. Where I have saved all the dry fruits. This is my second partition. This is my buttermilk which I prepared for the last night, and this is still pending, so I keep this buttermilk in a long sleek vessel like this so that it doesn't consume a lot of space. I use an organizer here, food organizer, to store some fresh fruits and vegetables. I keep all the seasonal fruits. This stays in polythene bag because I've not washed it yet. I have to wash it, so I've kept it in polythene bag. And the tender coconut pieces also, so that it doesn't get spoiled. The small box here, this is basically a box of masalas. Since it is a glass box, you can easily see all the... This is a glass box, so you can easily see which you want, and it becomes easy for you to take which you want. So excess of this masalas, I just save it here. The second rack looks like. So this is my first rack. In this rack, I've basically kept all those items which I use frequently. So here I have kept tomatoes. So I keep my tomatoes like this. So this is chili box. Removing the stalks like this from behind and placing them in a box or some airtight container like this, you can save your chilies for more days. So this is the trick how I use to keep my chilies. Normally what we do is we use this sort of patela to keep, and this requires a lot of space. So what I do is I don't use this. I take an airtight container box like this and just drop in some milk in this, whatever milk is left out, and I just place it like this so that this requires very less space also. So I suggest you to buy such boxes. Now this box I have got free with Govardhan ghee, so I'm using it. So this is how I store my milk. And next, if you see, this is another box wherein I have kept my curry leaves. So the video on how to store curry leaves, I have shared this already, and I'll be posting this link for this in description box. Kindly check it out. I have this box where I have kept some ginger and lemon. So I keep it again in a airtight container box like this. Now this is the airtight container box where I'm keeping my fresh coriander leaves again in a polythene bag like this. In case you prefer keeping some leftover foods, then you could also keep it like this milk powder, and you can keep this box over that box, and still there is ample amount of space where you can keep your leftovers or bread, whatever you like to. So this is how my first set looks like. I have my freezer here. So since this is a very very small freezer, so let me show you. This is a very small freezer. There is an ice tray, just in case I need some. There is an ice tray here, and there are some frozen peas, and there are some frozen vegetables, and this is a small box of ice cream, leftover ice cream here, and these are some sweet corns, frozen corns, which I've kept it again in an air container like this. So normally I don't keep a lot of stuffs here. So this is how my freezer looks like. Right below my freeze zone, there is a small tray that is coming up. So this is my rack where I normally keep all my dairy products, may it be some milk. Since I don't have a space to keep any food organizer here, and this tray itself acts as a good food organizer here, so I stuff it. There is still some space at the behind, you can look. So I just stuff it with milk, curd and some khoya paneer and some butter. This is how my free zone looks like. So friends, this is how my fridge looks like. I like it organizing like this, keeping very few stuffs, which makes my work easier. Please let us know you like this video by commenting below, and if any feedbacks or improvements, also comment us. And how do you maintain your fridge? Any tips, tricks, please feel free to comment down. And if you're not subscribed to our channel yet, please subscribe and do not forget to hit the bell icon. If you want more such videos on organizing, please comment below and let us know. Do not forget to thumbs up the video. Please subscribe. Thank you.